on behalf of Oliver Lodge, thank you for coming. We really appreciate it. This is like a dream coming true. It's like something happening that some of us thought would never happen. We're really, today, we're looking at a new building. But that's kind of the small part of it. We're celebrating a new opportunity in the city of Saskatoon to serve people who need to be cared for in a special care home. And that's really what this place is all about. Although you see the bricks and the mortar and you see the nice colors that Morley and I have picked out and you see all and you see all those things, what it's really about is what Morley is going to tell you. Please welcome our administrator, Morley Mitchell.
Thank you, Harold. First, I want to touch on something. This project has been in planning stages for about 20 years, and we've got.
This will be long. I'll sit down.
It is, and thank you, Harold. And we had somebody volunteer to do our fundraising back then, 20 years ago, Harold Empey, and he did a great job back then. When it came closer to having the project approved, Harold was instrumental in getting approval from the provincial government. From the city, I know he phoned every alderman before the meeting, and also with the health region. He's back raising funds for it again. So this project would not have happened without Harold Empey. So. Okay, what we're going to show you today is what we say is a state-of-the-art building. There's 89 beds in total. A lot of it is built on the concept of communities, mainly 16-bed communities, and we feel it's very important to have smaller groupings of residents with similar abilities. Each community has their own living room, dining room, and kitchenette. You'll see family rooms, stuff like that. And we also try to have the staff consistent in those communities, and we think that's quite important that you're dealing with some of the same people all the time, not a new face every day. We've been very fortunate that we've been able to load it with a lot of features. The track lift system that you see today is just excellent, and we know there'll be a lot less back injuries, and it'll be so much easier for the residents and the families, or pardon me, and our staff. Some of the other features you'll see are memory boxes outside each room. Our vigil call system is something you likely won't see a lot of, but especially for our people with dementia, they don't know enough to push a button to get help. And we monitor the residents. There's a sensor in the bed, one towards the bathroom, and one exiting the room. And we're able to determine in a computer when we want staff called. Some it might be as soon as the person gets out of bed. Some they might be 10 minutes, and we want the staff called then. So it's just an excellent way of providing a call system, especially for people with dementia. And then we have all sorts of tracking with that we can determine when people have been up. Maybe they're up at between 2 and 3 every night or something like that, and we're able to respond in that way. We've got outdoor space on every floor, including second and third. There's outdoor patios. Some of the other features, one of the little ones that I just mentioned to Maura was towel warmers. If you have a bath here, you come out, you get a warm towel. Things like that, the staff have done a lot to kind of plan and have the building done just right. So. Anyway, I'll turn it back to you, Harold. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks, Morley. Perhaps just take a minute to tell you what we're doing this last few days and the next 10 days. And that is, when we decided that this thing wasn't going to be officially opened until May, till everything's done, because there's another 2 or 3 months' work to do, we knew that when this part of the facility was ready, that there'd be some people interested. So we sat down and made a list of all the groups that we thought should come and have a look. You are the fifth group here. In total, we'll have somewhere between 12 and 14 groups. We've already had 350 people view this facility, and by the next Saturday night, over 850 will be viewing this facility. So it's in terms of the exposure, It's wonderful exposure to have that many people involved, and we're just delighted that you could come. And we have a special guest today. We've got to have the bosses talk to us. And so, Maura, would you please take the podium and make a few comments? Thank you very much.
Thanks, Harold. Good morning, and I'm just thrilled to be here. I was here visiting with Shan and Morley and Harold about 3 months ago, and it was in quite a different state then. So it's just very exciting to come and see it in a state where it's ready to welcome residents and families. As I was coming here this morning, I was actually thinking of my mom. And my mom died 3 years ago. She was 97. And she had spent the last 3 years of her life in a long-term care facility in PEI. And it was so important for me and my family to know that she was in an environment that was safe and where the staff who provided really exceptional care were supported in providing that care. And so what I was thinking this morning was all the people that are going to be served in this new facility, the residents and their families who will benefit from the thought, the diligence that you have put into every little detail. Certainly a thank you to the United Church and to the Angels of Care Foundation campaign group, because these things don't get built without financial support, and that's critically important. And I hope by showing off the fruits of your labors, others will support you in that continuing campaign. But I think what is apparent to me is you have put so much thought into making this a home. And many of the features, Morley, that you mentioned, the memory boxes particularly, I think are just a way to remind us that every resident who will live here has a story, and that life story is precious to us. So all of those details to make it a family setting, a home-like setting, but also the attention to the quality and the safety of the care is just amazing. The attention to preventing falls, to preventing infection, to providing special safe care for those residents who need particular attention because of their dementia. I think that is just so evident here in the work that you have to be so proud of. So I join you in congratulating you. This is just the best part of my week, I tell you, to be here and celebrating with you. So thank you for inviting me to join you.